once again, this your intel girl from the spirit world. Now, this is the intel on spiritual stalkers. Now, these are familiar from monitoring spirits. The thing is, these are in human form. These are vessels that literally spiritually stalk you. And majority, a lot of the times, they operating in witchcraft in some form or fashion. Or they were operating in new age methods and things like that to stalk people spiritually, to keep their eye on you, to see what you're doing. They'll use situations, they'll use tactics, they'll use prayers, they'll use chants, they even use the third eye to stalk you and to see what you're doing, to monitor everything you're doing. Human vessels. And then on top of that, sometimes they release spirits upon you to keep an eye on you, or to bring affliction, to bring confusion, to bring, you know, sabotaging. Now, I'll talk about spiritual sabotages, because they're a little bit of that or both, really. They, what their purpose is to sabotage everything you do in your life, everything you do in the spirit realm, everything you do in your assignment with God, everything. They can be at work, they can be at church, they can be in your family, they can be people that you think got your back, supposedly got your back. But literally, they're spiritually stalking you. And then you'll know from your discernment. That's why it's important to discern. That's why I'm giving you this intel now. Discern how people act around you spiritually. Discern how people act around you naturally. Because they can cover up. They can cover up so much. But their actions is going to tell you what they're doing. Their actions gonna let them know that what they're doing is trying to make sure that whatever you're doing does not go come to pass. Whatever you're trying to accomplish, it fails. Whatever you're trying to, go forth in is blocked, hindered, and stopped. And they don't even need the devil's help on that, even though he's part of it, cause he co-signs on anything we're doing that's demonic and satanic and witchcraft. He is a co-signer. He may not be the author of it, but he all up in there. Especially if you open that door and that portal. That's why it's important as people of God and children of God that you don't get to the point where you literally stalking folks spiritually because you want what they want. And a lot of it rooted in jealousy, envy, and hatred. Spiritual stalking. You're stalking people spiritually. You're calling them to see what they're doing. You're trying to control their methods, their works, their deeds. You're trying to control everything they do. That's stalking too. And then it gets to the point where they try to control. Because the more they stalking, the more they try to control the narrative in your life, control your actions and your deeds. And then that's how you know you got a stalker in your midst. Now, Missy Lee Shed, how do we deal with these spiritual stalkers? I'm glad you asked that question. First of all, you need to pray and seek the Lord and see what is stalking you. What vessel's being used? Because it's a human vessel. Being used. What are they trying to do? What is their motive? What is their goal? What is their aim? And God reveal it to you in your fasting and in your praying time. Once you find out what it is, you got to rebuke it, shut it down, and block it in the spirit of prayer. For example, Father God, in the name of Jesus, any spiritual stalkers, sabotages, I rebuke and bind up their work in the name of Jesus and send it back to the sender. And every third eye that's being unauthorized, I pluck it out. Every unmonitoring spirit they have released, I rebuke in the name of Jesus. And then on top of that, you can add more to that. And then if it comes to a point where you have to confront these vessels and let them know they need to stop, it has the Lord lead you. Don't do that on your own. But the Lord had to tell you, that's why it's important to confront. You got to confront sometimes things in your life that is happening in the natural. And you dealing with folks, grown folks, folks that know what they're doing. And then prayer, you have prayed it. They keep on doing it naturally. Sometimes you got to shut it down in the natural. That's why it's a time to confront. Sometimes you're going to have to confront spiritual stalkers, just like they got to confront stalkers in the world. They got to take them to court and let them know, you need to stop stalking me. Because the purpose is to bring intimidation and fear. And always watching your back all the time. Wondering who's doing this, who's doing that. And wondering why you're getting unexpected phone calls, unexpected situations. Then they could be sneaky and sly with it. Well, they stalking you, and then they trying to harass you at the same time. Then sabotage and undermine you. So this is all with the intel about spiritual stalkers. Because all they doing is trying to stalk you to sabotage you. They trying to stalk you to control you. Whatever their motive is, you got to deal with it, confront it in the spirit. And if you got to deal with it in the natural, and have some come to Jesus meetings with them, with these vessels, then do so. Because it's not of God. And this is from personal experience. A lot of this intel I'm giving you is from personal experience that I have dealt with. And some of the stuff I'm dealing with now. Because folks will stalk you to the very end. Especially if they've been using and abusing you. Especially if they have been undermining you. Especially if they've been lying on you. Especially if they've been sowing discord. Oh yeah, they're stalking. With conversation. That's why I discern. Discern text, conversations, what people are doing. God will reveal. Holy Ghost will reveal to you stuff. Then he'll give you a strategy on how to handle all that. So, rebuke these spiritual stalkers and sabotagers. And don't let it get the best of you. Don't operate in your flesh and go off on them. Because there's been some points where Elise before she got saved and delivered and set free. And trying to stay delivered and set free and full of glory would have went off on folks. Because people get tired. You know, even in the world, some people know when people shiesty and not right. They call it intuition. It's called natural discernment. You know they ain't right. You know what they're doing. And you want to front them out. But God gives you a way to deal with it. But be aware of who you hanging around and who's smiling in your face. And not even at church. Who praying with you? Who's sitting by you? Who's supposed to be, you know, a co-laborer in the Lord? Because some of your spiritual stalkers is the ones that's on the prayer team. Sometimes they over there ministering and preaching and prophesying right next to you. And then they go to their little house, their little private sector, and start chatting and praying stuff against you, trying to see what you're doing, trying to release new age ideals, amulets, crystal balls, and stuff like that to keep their eye on you spiritually. And then if they can't do that, then they'll find some other. Then I'm going on full intel. This happened for experience. They will talk to somebody else who not really watching they supposed to. Not discerning like they supposed to. They'll go to somebody else to fish information from that person so they can see what you're doing, so they can continue to release more stalking and more spirits and more natural things to happen to keep you all out of whack, vexed, depressed, oppressed, frustrated. So know your environment, know who's around you, know your environment, and seek the Lord on this, because this is real. And if you couple this with monitoring spirits too, you already got, you got natural spiritual stalkers. Then you got spirits always trying to monitor you too. So that's a double. You got monitoring spirits and spirit. That's why I say, when God reveals that intel to you in the spirit, shut it down. Whatever strategy he give you, do that strategy. Because he going to deliver and set us free out of all afflictions. Even when folks do afflictions on you. So, keep on with the intel. There'll be more intel from the spirit girl, Maybe you should like, subscribe to this channel. Share this video. It's bad, bad. People didn't know. There's some folks out there that they be prophesying, speaking in tongues, and stalking you on the down low. Using the Bible, using books I saw in the Half Price bookstore on conjuring spirits and spells and potions and stuff like that. Be smiling, grinning in your face. They be the main spiritual stalkers. Main ones. The ones you don't think. Like David said, I could have took it from my brother. I could have took it from my enemy. But it was my brother, my equal. Those be your main spiritual stalkers. So keep on discerning and praying with purpose and power, and check your portals.